Hey everyone, Ricky here from Ricky's Tech Talk. In this video, we're going to set up the brand new Honor Magic 4 Lite. So you may have just got your new device, but actually, how do you set it up? So in a step-by-step way, I'm going to go through the setup process. It all begins by powering your device on. So down the right-hand side, you're going to find your volume controls, which are closer to the top. And in the middle is an indented button, which is your fingerprint sensor and your power switch. Press and hold the power button to turn your device on, and then it welcomes you to the setup screen. Before continuing, I just want to highlight the accessible options that are available at the beginning. So at the bottom right hand corner, there's an option called Reading Aid. Once inside here, you have two options, which is magnification and font size. So let's go into magnification. So what you need to do is toggle this on, and then you have a couple of options. So you can tap the display three times with a single finger and it will zoom in and out. You can press and hold on your third tap if you do it again, and it will zoom in and zoom out automatically for you. So that's magnification, a very good option to have. The other option is to change your font size. So inside here, you'll see a preset sample, and you can use the scroll bar at the bottom to make the text larger. This will then make the text a lot easier to read during the setup process, as I'm visually impaired and it's much needed when going through a new device and setting up a new device. Our first step is to select English as our language. Then you need to select your region. So scroll down, find your region, and then press next. Then we come onto our terms of use, and this is the terms and conditions that you need to agree to. There's a box halfway down and you press next to continue. Then you have the option to insert your SIM card. I'm just going to skip for the process of the video. The next step is then asking us to connect to a Wi-Fi network. So you're going to find your Wi-Fi network and input your password. Once you've inputted your password, hit connect and it will start to connect to your Wi-Fi network. Once it's connected, it will be highlighted in blue. Then you can press next. Your device now will start to check for updates. This device is running Magic UI 4.2, which is based off Android 11, which means it's fully compatible with all Google apps and services. The next step is to copy apps and data. So if you choose next, it mentions you can copy from an old Android device, you can copy from a backup which is in the cloud, or you can copy from an iPhone. I'm going to say don't copy though. The next step on our journey is to sign in with Google. If you don't have a Google account, you can create one. Also, you can skip. If you did sign in with your Google account, it will ask you to use your mobile phone number to keep your device secure and updated. There's terms and conditions that you need to read here. So just say, yes, I'm in, and it continues. Then it has the Google terms and conditions that you need to agree to. So just click agree to move on. The next page will show you the Google services that you can agree to. Most of mine are ticked because I use these on a daily basis, especially when testing a new device. The only one that I may switch off is Google Backup. So just go through and select the ones you want and then tap accept. The next section asks about accessing assistant with Hey Google, and you can set this process up if you need to. I already have my voice match on file, so it's just going to download my option here, but again, I just have to give it permission to do so. Then it says access your assistant without actually unlocking your device. Again, you can choose to do this or you can say skip. Please note a pop-up for data and privacy will come up. I'm just going to agree to this and continue. The next section we have to go through is device protection. So there's a few options. You can set up a fingerprint ID, you can set up face recognition or a password. So I'm going to do the fingerprints ID, but you have to set a passcode. You do have the option to change to a 4-digit passcode, a PIN or a pattern. And then what you'll need to do is enter that PIN. And then what you need to do is place your finger or thumb on your power button, which is down the right hand side. If you use the case, it's very easy to feel because it has an indentation. All you do then is highlight your fingerprint on the screen just by tapping and lifting your thumb on and off that power button. No need to press it, just lightly tap it on that power button and you can see it fill in the fingerprint on the front of the screen. It will let you know once it's completed and then tap OK. Then you have the option to set up face recognition. I'm going to skip for the moment and then you've got enhanced services. Again, this is from Honor. Again, you can agree to these or you can miss out if you want to. Then you have your user experience program. Again, agree to this. Then finally, your location services, which you'll need to agree to. Then it moves on to the new navigation system, so it uses gesture controls. So swiping in from the left will go back. Swiping from the right, again, will bring you out of your large image. Swiping up will take you home. And then swiping up and holding will show you your app drawer where all of your apps are. There's an easy dismiss button for all of them. That is gestures, nice and easy. And then finally you press the button and you're welcome into your home screen and your device is all set up and ready to go. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to leave a comment below underneath that like button. Thank you so much for watching and I will see you in my next video. If you want to see more videos on the Honor Magic 4 Lite, check out these two videos here. And if you haven't already, make sure to subscribe and ring that notification bell to stay updated when I release new videos. From me, Ricky, carry on having a great day.